morning to all of you. Today we're going to discuss law of independent assortment and dihybrid crops. Okay, so in our previous lecture we have discussed in detail about how the alleles are separated during the gamete formation and how they get assorted on chromosome after the formation of zygote. Okay, so what is law of independent assortment? As I have told you earlier in our previous lecture, so let's revise again. So what is the law of independent assortment? It is, this law shows how genes, ये law क्या दिखाता है? How genes separate independently. How genes separate independently when? During the time of gamete formation. Okay, meiotic division or meiosis occurs and thus gametic formation or gametic cell formation takes place. So this law shows that how genes separate independently from one another during gamete formation. Okay, so during gamete formation how genes separate independently and thus, and this this law is based on dihybrid clause. When we say dihybrid, di means two, that means inheritance, that means inheritance of two different genes. We can say two different allelic pairs which are carrying two different traits or characters. Okay, so this is based on dihybrid cross, and as you have studied about monohybrid cross, that is inheritance of a single gene responsible for a single trait, could be height, shape, color, whatever. So dihybrid means inheritance of two genes or inheritance of two allelic pairs carrying or responsible for two different traits or characters. Okay, based on dihybrid cross, which shows, ये क्या दिखाता है? Which shows genes for the shape of seed, means genes or allelic pairs which are responsible for shape of seed and color of seed. Here we are talking about two different traits. One is shape and color of seed are assorted together. वो साथ में assort होते हैं, इकट्ठे बैठते हैं वो. क्रोमोसोम के ऊपर लोकेशंस उनकी ऑलमोस्ट एक दूसरे के बिल्कुल पास रहती हैं. दे असोर्टेड टुगेदर एंड एक्सप्रेसिंग इंडिपेंडेंटली. सो हियर एक्चुअली वी आर प्रूविंग डाइहाइब्रिड क्रॉस, दैट मींस वी आर इनहेरिटिंग टू ट्रेट्स, कलर एंड शेप, एंड थ्रू डाइहाइब्रिड क्रॉस एक्चुअली we prove this law of independent assortment. And how this happens? Look at here. As you know, we would start with having pure parents. We have these pure parents, capital R, capital R, capital I, capital Y, small r, small r, small r, so small y, small y. Actually, मैं एक बार जिन लोग बच्चों को पता नहीं चला है, मैं एक बार फिर से बता दूं, ये actually में है क्या चीज़ है? सिंबल्स हैं किसी जीन्स को रिप्रेजेंट करने के लिए. सारे के सारे अलग अलग जीन्स हैं. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 है ये 8 जीन्स. लेकिन हमने इन दोनों को आर आर क्यों लिखा है? जीन 1 और जीन 2 को हमने आर आर क्यों लिखा है? द रीजन इज बिकॉज बोथ ऑफ दीज जीन्स आर रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर अ सिंगल ट्रेट और अ सिंगल ट्रेट. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, बोथ ऑफ दीज जीन्स are responsible for the shape of a seed. Okay, तो इसलिए हमने दोनों को एक ही सिंबल से या एक ही इंग्लिश लेटर से हम लोग उसको रिप्रेजेंट करते हैं. Similarly, this Y, both of these genes are responsible for the color of seed. Capital letter represents dominant gene and small letter represents recessive gene. So, and when two genes are responsible for a single or a same trait, then these genes are known as alleles. तब हम इनको क्या बोलते हैं alleles and they are forming a pair दो हैं इसमें तो हमें क्या बोलते हैं इनको allelic pair. So here you can see 1, 2, 3 and 4 four allelic pairs are there. They are assorted together in order to express themselves independently. इस allelic pair का एक अपना trait है एक अपना expression है round shape इसका अपना है yellow color. इस allelic pair का अपना है wrinkled shape and this allelic pair green color. Okay. So as I have said in my previous lecture that the condition in law of independent assortment is all of these allelic pairs or the allelic pairs for both of these traits have to be assorted together in order to express themselves independently. यानी दोनों को साथ में बैठना पड़ेगा एक साथ ही लोकेट होना पड़ेगा क्रोमोसोम के ऊपर. अगर ये साथ में असॉर्ट नहीं होंगे देन दे कुड नॉट एक्सप्रेस देमसेल्व्स. ओके ओनली कंडीशन इज दैट दे हैव टू बी असॉर्ट टुगेदर. ओके दीज आर प्योर पेरेंट्स और फोर एलीलिक पेयर्स टू डोमिनेंट्स एंड टू रिसेसिव होमोजाइगेट होमोजाइगस कंडीशन. ओके दीज आर द फिनोटाइप्स. What happens if we cross them or if we cross these pure parents, recessive and dominant? What happens first? Here we do apply or this law of segregation applies over here. So, so we have a law of segregation apply hota. That means the separation of genes okay, during the time of gamete formation. So, yahan pe kya ho raha hai? इस एलीलिक पेयर से एक कैपिटल आर को आगे जाने का मौका मिला इसमें से एक को. सिमिलरली यहां से ये यहां से ठीक. सो नाउ वी आर गेटिंग अ हाइब्रिड कंडीशन और हेटरोजाइगोट कंडीशन दैट इज कैपिटल आर स्मॉल आर. जब हम डेटा लिखेंगे क्योंकि दोनों के दोनों किसके लिए हैं शेप के लिए रिस्पॉन्सिबल है. दिस वाई कैपिटल वाई स्मॉल वाई बोथ ऑफ दीज जीन्स आर रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर कलर. So they are known as alleles and they have to be right together. So capital R, small r, small y, capital Y, small y. This is heterozygote condition and their phenotype and then this is hybrid. Okay, means mixing of both homozygote, recessive and dominant allelic pairs. The phenotype is round shape because of having this capital R in this allelic pair. This capital R is responsible for round shape. This small r is responsible for wrinkled shape. As I have written over here, capital R, round shape, capital Y, yellow color, small r, wrinkled shape, and small y is green color. That means round shape and yellow color is dominant trait. Wrinkled shape and green color is recessive trait. Okay, so this is the hybrid we have got. Okay, now we going to self cross this hybrid heterozygote allelic pairs. Now we are going to self cross. हम क्या करेंगे? Self cross करेंगे and product square बनेगा यहाँ पे. And here you can see when we do self cross this capital R small r capital Y small y this hybrid, we would get actual four possibilities or four allelic pairs. Capital Y, capital R, capital Y, capital R, small R, capital Y, small Y. These are four different allelic pairs or four different possibilities when we do cross these hybrids. Okay, and now we would actually go for this dihybrid cross. इन सभी पॉसिबिलिटीज के साथ यानी सिमिलरली नीचे आ गया ये. ओके एक्चुअली ये मेल को रिप्रेजेंट करता है ये फीमेल को रिप्रेजेंट करता है मेल एंड फीमेल एलीलिक पेयर्स. ओके व्हेन वी डू क्रॉस हमारे पास ये आया इसको इससे किया दिस वन लाइक दिस वी हैव दिस एक्चुअली द आउटकम ऑफ दिस क्रॉस द हाइब्रिड क्रॉस. Simple example, when we do cross this capital and capital Y with this capital and capital Y, we would get this one. Capital I, capital Y. And the phenotype would be round and yellow. Round shape, yellow color. इस तरह से हमने इस सारे इस सिस्टम को हम लोगों ने इन सारे एलिलिक पेयर्स को आपस में हमने क्रॉस किया एंड आफ्टर क्रॉसिंग व्हाट वुड वी गेट फिनोटिपिक एंड जीनोटिपिक रेशियो फिनोटिपिक एज यू नो दिस अ मॉर्फोलॉजिकल एट दिस एक्चुअली फिनोटाइप रिप्रेजेंट्स मॉर्फोलॉजिकल कैरेक्टर्स ट्रेट्स और कॉन्ट्रास्टिंग फीचर्स व्हिच डू अपीयर बिफोर अस व्हेनेवर वी सी or observe them with our naked eyes, like height, color, shape, etc. And genotype is all about genetic makeup. Okay, that means this allelic pair could be a homozygote or heterozygote, like that. Okay, capital means a dominant gene, recessive gene. How is the pairing of genes or alleles? Okay, so genotype is all about genetic makeup. So what is the phenotypic ratio? We have 9 possibilities of round shape and yellow color. Okay, like this round and yellow. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. So 9 allelic pairs, ठीक है? यहाँ पे इनका phenotype क्या रहेगा? Round and yellow. Similarly, round and green, 3, 3, wrinkled and yellow, wrinkled and green. So the phenotypic ratio would be 9:3:3:1. ये आपको याद रखनी है, ठीक है? This must be remembered by you. If ये पूछते हैं, what is the phenotypic ratio of dihybrid cross? As we have actually read about the monohybrid cross. The phenotypic ratio in monohybrid cross was 3:1 and genotypic ratio was 1:2:1. The genotypic ratio in case of dihybrid cross is 1:2:1:2:4:2:1:2:1. So this is a genotypic ratio, means all about the genetic makeup of these outcomes we have through this dihybrid cross, and thus the inheritance of two different genes actually what is the resultant, what has been proved through this dihybrid cross? The inheritance of two different genes assorted together and expressing themselves independently. To know more about how this independent assortment takes place, how genes get separated, do watch my previous lecture on independent assortment, where I have told you about how the genes are separated, how genes they get assorted on chromosomes and express themselves independently. So it's all about independent assortment and dihybrid cross, this phenotypic ratio and genotypic ratio and inheritance of two genes. Tomorrow we will discuss about polygenic inheritance, means polygenes, and pleiotropy. Thank you.